Better get a handle on those suckers. You're going to need them.
You're a real funny guy, Nick.
I know.
Real hilarious. All right, let's restart Dark Souls here. Well, that's real shitty. I was, well, probably just about to get killed, but...
Oops.
That's okay.
Well, hopefully it'll autosave for you at a nice convenient moment.
Yeah, I think I'll be, like, getting ready to fight the channeler. Chat, if you can hear me, my internet just went out for a second there, which is hilarious considering I just told you how good the uptime was.
Chandler Bing.
Don't talk to me about Chandler Bing, okay? We've gone over this so many times.
Nobody even uses that for search anymore.
Apparently Bill Gates does. Oh, sweet.
He would. Yeah.
Big ups to Steam for showing my CD key for Dark Souls Prepare to Die Edition.
Oh, somebody's going to steal it now.
Yep, there you go. If they, you know, more power to you, I guess, because, like, who's this Quick Bro? There we go. More power to you. Every Paradox game also does that. It always shows you this code. And every time, I'm just like, it's all right, man. No worries.
Every time, you don't actually ever need it.
Yep, I've never needed to use that code, except for, like, games with really terrible DRM, which are just like, you know, you need to input the 16-digit code, even though you bought it with your credit card from a digital store mere seconds ago.
Right.
No. Oh, God, I'm going to get hurt in the butt by the hollows. It's my favorite.
Do you remember how to bait this dragon?
You don't bait the dragon, Nick. Oh, God, I fucking died. They totally destroyed my momentum, man.
He doesn't want to come down.
Oh, thanks a lot, Shaw.
No. I'm not going to be able to bait the dragon.
Don't talk to me about baiting the dragon, Nick. This stream is rated E. Yeah, Chad, I really scumbagged my way out of that invasion. Just so I can get killed by all of the freaking hollows simultaneously. If I was going to cheat, I would just put on a trainer and take myself to level 99 without anybody noticing. Anyway.
I might notice because your chat would tell me.
No, they wouldn't, Nick. They wouldn't. I promise.
Wow, that'd be scummy, chat. Don't do that.
This I promise you by Enrique Iglesias. Okay. There's one death. NL death count one. That's okay. We're still only 35 minutes in. We got a lot of time.
Hey, chat, can you help me wreck this dragon, please? And bait him?
You're supposed to run past that guy. Did you not see me try to run past that man?
No, I'm trying to get him to come down so I could run past him.
Don't talk to me about the dragon, Nick. You put yourself into that situation.
Alright, I think we're good now. Is he stomping? No, he's not stomping!
What are you trying to- you trying to get the Drake Sword, like an ultimate scum?
No, I'm not trying to get the Drake Sword, I'm just trying to run below him.
Chat, is Nick trying to get the Drake Sword, like an ultimate scum?
You think my chat would tell you?
I think they would tell me. I know they would tell me.
It's not very fair.
Dude, in the war against the Drake Sword, we're all in this together.
Alright, I'm abandoning the dragon, he can bait himself then.
Wow. Alright. Hollows, please. Hollows. There we go. All right. So we use. Who are you supposed to use the black fire bombs against?
Your mother.
Wow.
I don't actually know. They're just like another stupid thing you can throw at stuff. If you don't have fireballs, but I do have fireballs, so I don't care.
Yeah, but I thought like there was an enemy that I almost always use the black fire bombs against.
Well, if you're trying to be kind of weird about it, you could use them on the boar, but. I would just use the skulls.
I may have done that, but I think I typically just use the skulls.
Skulls are way easier. Or just don't even fight him. It's also an option.
You have to fight him.
I don't.
You have to fight him. Do I still have gold pine resin? I do. Okay, Channeler's dead. Don't say... I heard the your brain gears turning to say...
I actually said it out loud.
Did you say Chandler Bing?
Very quietly I said it out loud, yes.
That's a good way to cheat the system. You use black fire bombs and fire bombs to cheese the Capra demon over the wall. That actually makes sense.
Nobody does that anymore.
You just kind of stand on the wall and then murder the dogs.
Old meta.
Yeah.
I don't want to die here. This is kind of bad because I need to level and get strength up so I can use the Uchi Katana.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm in the boar room now, which is like so old.
I'm glad to hear that. I'm about to fight the gargoyles. You're actually pretty close, then, in that case. Because Undead Parish is pretty short.
If I made it through here before this dude could lower this gate, which I did.
Oh, no. I didn't realize you could actually skip the cutscene with the gargoyles. So I, like, went to drink my coffee, and then one of them just came at me with, like, axe blazing.
They do blaze their axes.
Is that you? I do.
I would, if I could.
Yeah, 420 Blaze Axe.
That's actually the very first time I made it through that gate without it shutting in front of me.
That's like a new meta as well that I don't ascribe to.
You should try it. It actually just cut off like 5 minutes of me doing stupid crap.
Of all that you know about me, the number one thing that you should know is that if something works, I never change it.
Okay, that's kind of why it's hard for me to do speedruns too, actually.
That's basically my reason for existence. I come up with my own methods for things, and then if they work, then I just try to make that method even better, even if that method itself is like orders of magnitude worse than the ideal.
I understand.
Yep, I'm glad to hear that, because a lot of people don't.
I have similar habits, so.
Solaire is still alive. Solaire, please actually kill one of them. I swear to God, when I played Dark Souls...
What's your problem?
When I played Dark Souls on the 360, Solaire was like the baddest ass in all of Lordran, who wasn't afraid of anything and just beat the shit out of everyone. And then on the PC version, he is the biggest pussy who is the worst at everything ever and is mad because he's bad.
The first time when you said that, you were actually thinking of Iron Tarkus, who's the most badass motherfucker this side of the universe.
Tarkus is amazing.
I mean, his name is Iron, he means it. It's really true.
What's the matter? Couldn't it be like Platinum Tarkus?
It doesn't need to be any more than that. Nobody else is more than Iron.
Is it the Iron Age? Are we still in the Iron Age right now? Is that what you're trying to imply?
We're in the Fire Age or something, right? Is the
this
bonfire?
Is the Age of Darkness, man.
Age of Reason. I
don't
know
what it is. Iframe, you nerd. I don't even know what that means. Is that like something you put on your website? You put an iframe in there so that...
That actually is totally a website thing.
I thought so. I've been involved in website production before, and maybe I would use an iframe to put like an ad or something on my site.
Yeah, you shouldn't use it. Nobody uses them anymore, but
yeah,
they were a thing.
It was like a mid-2000s thing.
Right.
Okay, Nick, I'm not going to beat the gargoyle.
All right, that's good news. That means I'm actually going to get to catch up to you then.
I don't understand how you scums are actually like pretty good at these guys. Because for me, like, unless Solaire actually manages to kill one, which happens once every 6,900 times, I just lose.
Yeah, I really don't have much trouble with them. I don't know. I just don't.
Use,
just the way it is.
Use a resin.
No? Well, maybe.
If you had one, I guess, maybe.
This it just sort of works out.
This is going to be a long fight, man.
That's fine. I would hope so.
I may still win, but it's not looking great.
So
one hit at a time.
Shortcut, reinforce my Estus again. Go back to Firelink.
Double Estus reinforce.
Yeah.
That's pretty
scummy. I get basically a full life bar from one of these now.
That's pretty scummy, Nick.
Well, I mean, I have more Estus than you, so I might live.
You have a freaking time. You have more time than me, because I'm just taking 100 years on this fight. NL, I would never go at the gargoyles with a short sword. Okay, that's actually like a really good point. I am still using the starting weapon. I don't care about equipment. Again, I beat Dark Souls without worrying about equipment, and then that has become the death of me because that is now my attitude and my reality now.
I'm hoping this Uji Katana is gonna get me through the whole game.
I can't believe this fucker got the Uji Katana.
It's the best option, I think.
It may be the best option.
I guess the lightning spear is not bad either, but it's kind of two different things.
Oh, right. I will probably get the lightning spear. Let's be honest. My odds of making it to Sen's Fortress, pretty not great.
No, you're going to make it.
Well, I mean, given enough time, I would, but...
You still got plenty of time. It's 42 after right now.
Short sword is what NL calls his ding-dong. Sometimes it's the simple comments that get you in chat.
Are you going to get hung up on Capra? Is that what you're thinking?
Dude, I'm still fighting the gargoyles. The same battle.
Yeah, but that's not going to last you much longer, and you've
got over
an hour left.
I may die. It's actually ended up being kind of better than expected, but still pretty bad. Holy
right,
shit, that one should be dead.
Gear, don't fail me now.
Beer, don't fail me now.
Oh, I said gear, but that too. If I had beer.
Oh, here we go. Oh, you moved out of the way the last second. NL got Thea. I'm going to take that to mean NL's got this, and I respect you for that, Chad.
You got this.
I don't know. One of them is very nearly dead, but I can't seem to hit him. I can only hit his companion, who is slightly less dead.
Is he a cube?
I don't even get the reference.
You shouldn't really.
Is it a Doctor Who reference?
It is.
I companion knew it!
Cube. Companion cubes from Doctor Who.
Excuse me. I was born at night, but it wasn't last night.
That would be weird if you were, though.
Yeah, that would be... I was born last night, AMA.
How did you pull that off? You're like, you've been streaming for years.
Yeah.
Fetus, and yet you're only just
most people
fetal
didn't know.
Streaming.
Fetal streaming, indeed.
That must be why you're so good at Binding of Isaac, because you can sympathize with the protagonist.
Yeah, in most video games, that's how you get good. You just sympathize.
Worse for me.
All right, Nick, I have killed one of the gargoyles. It took me 1,000 humanity. I'm not very pleased.
Did you rescue Lautrec?
No.
I think I'm going to get him, because I can knock him off the cliff really easily and get some get a ring or something.
Lautrec's a garbage man.
See, who's got the fap ring? Is it him?
Yeah, he's got the ring of favor and protection. I don't call it what you call it, because what you call it is offensive.
To who?
And vulgar. To people.
The Viking.
People. It's offensive to people. Here we go. Oh, I dodged it. Okay. Two more attacks, and this dude should be Volgar the Viking. I don't know what that's supposed to mean. I guess it's supposed to mean dead.
You can do this. No. I believe in you.
I appreciate that, Nick. You know, this is always my problem, is that on a mechanical level, I'm sort of okay at Dark Souls, but I'm so lazy.
Yeah, sometimes you gotta kind of counteract your own laziness and do a little bit extra, which is my way of getting through the beginning.
Yeah, I just don't prepare. I did beat
Preparation goes a long way.
So, you know, it only took 45 minutes for me to beat the gargoyles.
Was it really? I don't think it was quite 45 minutes.
Well, to be fair, I did spend 10 minutes, you know, well, not 10 minutes, but several minutes with the whole invasion and my internet cutting out and then dying to the hollows.
We should add up all the theoretical time that you've posited and then add up how much time.
Oh, and then, yeah, then subtract it. That's how you do a world record here. That's how you calculate the world record. That's why whenever like there's an Olympian and they finish in like second or third place, they just go to the judge and they're like, "Well, how would I have done if I actually trained harder?" And the judge is like, "Oh, that would have taken half a second off your time." And then they give them the gold medal.
I should have gone human.
For what?
To summon Solaire. Now I'm going to have to fight the gargoyles. You know what? I'm going to take the extra time, go human and come back.
Oh, wow. Nick's on the gargoyles now, I see.
Because I'm also going to spend a bunch of these souls, so because I'm probably going to die on the first go.
Oh.
Got lots of humanity.
Nick, do you know what I also always forget every time I do the Dark Souls early game?
What's that?
I always forget to get the key off of that dude in Undead Parish that opens up the door to Anor Londo, or Lower Undeadburg. Now, I didn't take any time to do basically anything, but I did take the time to learn, well, what is it? That's pretty important.
Your priorities are so in order.
Mm-hmm.
Should you go get a Man Serpent Greatsword?
I should, actually. You can't until you ring the second bell, though.
Oh, right. They come out of the... For some reason, I just thought they were on the bridge.
I don't want to be...
Not true.
Like I did that day. Take me to the place I love. Take me all the way.
No.
That's under the bridge. Sometimes I feel like I don't have a partner. The song basically describes us right now.
Yeah.
We have each
Josh?
Other, but...
Is he okay?
There's no Josh.
No, Josh.
How, what was I going to say here? What have you been playing this week, Nick? This is what I like when it's just... I love having Josh on the show, don't get me wrong. But it's nice when it's just you and I as well. We can actually have, the serious-ish conversations.
You don't even want to know what I've been playing this week.
Whoa.
It's been crazy.
What have you been playing this week?
I started a new series that I'm probably going to cancel after the first episode called Indie Games from Hell, where basically I just have no words for the games that are going to be in this. So it's like 2 minutes of sheer insanity followed by a break in reality, and then the video ends.
You should play Game Tycoon 1.5.
Why?
It's real bad.
Oh.
Like, real bad.
I don't want to do that. That sounds awful.
When I told you the name, did you think it was a sequel to Game Dev Tycoon?
Absolutely did. 100%.
Yep. It's not. And that is, you know, it's pretty scummy.
They're not taking advantage of that, are they?
I think they might be. They called their game Game Tycoon 1.5. It's not Game Dev Tycoon 1.5. But then when you boot up the game, it just says Game Tycoon. Beats me, man.
Yeah, don't do that.
Also, it's just real terrible as well. And also, apparently, when it launched on Steam, it launched without an EXE, which is just hilarious.
What?
I know, right? Like, how does that?
What does that even mean?
Like, it launched without an EXE.
So, what is there then when you finish downloading it?
The digital manual and like the README.
So you double click on it, and then what?
Beats
nothing.
Me. And you know what's fucked up is that the people who actually got the game without the EXE probably got the better end of the deal.
You know what's fucked up is that the game launched without an EXE.
Well,
to be honest.
That is, if you want to be objective and honest, yeah, that's the most fucked up part.
Well, if you want to be my lover, you got to get with my friends.
Make it last forever.
Friendship never ends.
Can we discuss that song? Because I don't really get it. What's her reasoning?
Haven't we gone over this before?
I just don't get her point. So she says, if you want to be my lover, got to get with my... Oh, shouldn't have done that. Got to get with my friends. Yeah, okay.
Yeah?
So that just means, like, be friends with my friends, I'm assuming.
No, it means you've got to have sex with them.
All right, well, then even that makes a little bit of logical sense, because then the friends, like, test drive the dude for her, right? And then they
report
back. Yeah,
they're all compatible.
Yeah, and they're like, yo, yeah, he's real good at what he does with the thing with his tongue. And then they're like, okay. But then make it last forever, friendship
never ends.
I kind of don't get that part. Actually, now that I thought about it, maybe it's like, if you want to be, you know, my significant other, you've got to be friends with my friends because I'm more likely to break up with you than I am to stop hanging out with my friends because friendship lasts forever.
But also the relationship might not last forever, right? So those two things together might be self-terminating.
Right.
I'm not sure there's an end to that.
I'm just going to go ahead and tell you that I don't know if they necessarily went through all of the, you know, like tautological potential issues with the game. With the song.
Yeah, I think you're right about that, because I actually just kind of broke my brain trying to think about it myself.
So did you know that apparently you can just go Valley of Drakes to Blighttown?
Hell yeah.
Oh,
that's
wait.
What I was planning on doing.
No, but wait, I'm thinking, I always go fight Capra. Why do I go fight Capra?
Because you want to fight Capra, I don't know.
Capra gives you the key to the depths where you get the ember.
Yeah, you want the ember, apparently. I don't care about that.
I mean, oh, so we can just go Valley of Drake's Blighttown.
If you feel like it, yeah. You should probably not, though, because it'll make it take way longer for you.
But I have the halberd now.
I mean, sure. Like,
gym halberd.
Do it if you want.
Unable to wield this with effective stats. Or with present stats.
Also, my magic trainer is going to be in the depths, so that could be a problem for me if I don't deal with that.
You need 16 strength and 12 hand.
Got two. 12 hand? Is that a new stat?
I think it's dexterity. He's so
lost.
Oh,
that hand.
I'm not lost. I'm just going back to the Firelink Shrine to level up and then go down to the Valley of the Drakes and then go to Blighttown, because apparently you don't need to fight Capra Demon unless you want to actually beat the game, but let's be honest.
You should probably try fighting Capra Demon. I'd really like to see you do that.
Nick, don't cheese me.
I would never.
All right. Use
never.
Both hands. Yeah, I understand you could use both hands. There we go. We got a real weapon here now. Should I kill Lautrec?
No.
He's actually pretty annoying to kill for the most part.
Actually, if you catch him in Firelink, you just kick him off the ledge in one move. That's
what I did. I used my halberd, and it just, like, pushed him off the edge. Sorry about that.
Did you find 12 hands yet?
I did. I'm wielding the halberd effectively. So somebody in chat is like... Actually, a few people in chat are like, you scum, get better internet. I have 0 frames dropped since we've come back, like, 20 minutes ago. So
yeah. You
might have... you know, the internet. You might be the one who needs better internet, chat. Yeah.
Also, if you heard him before, he said he had like 100 down.
Yeah.
Which is crazy.
Are you jealous?
Really, I am, honestly, yeah.
What's the matter? Couldn't it be 31 less? Get the ring, NL. Don't you just like reload in Firelink Shrine and then you get the ring?
Yes.
Yeah, see? I don't want to reload right now. I'll reload later after I die. For now, I'm just going to go to Blighttown. Plus, that's like a huge commitment. Once you take that ring on, you put that ring on, you can't take it off.
Why would you ever take that ring off?
Well, I don't know, because maybe you want to put on the Artorias Covenant that allows you to not just fall through the ground when you go to fight those guys.
Nobody ever wears that ring.
Nobody ever makes the first jump.
That's enough. Neo does.
Neo does not make the first jump. I'm beginning to think...
Oh, yeah, no, he wiggles on the ground.
I'm beginning
right.
to think you haven't seen the original film, The Matrix, Nick.
It's a classic movie. Of course I've seen it.
It came out the same year as Austin Powers' International Man of Mystery.
Henceforth, why I called it a classic.
That makes a lot of sense.
Hey, you got a gargoyle helm on first try here.
Nice. Must be nice for you. The fat dudes from Blighttown are chasing me. That's okay, though. One of them managed to hit me with his club and poison me.
You might want to get Manager Mildred for this fight.
Obviously I'm going to get Manager Mildred for this fight, Nick.
Okay.
I was born at night, but it wasn't last night.
Oh. I'm ringing the bell now.
That's a good thing. Maybe soon after that you can actually catch up with me.
I'll be right there with you in just a moment.
You should go fight the Capra Demon.
Wait a minute. You almost got me on that one.
Give it a try, Nick. See what happens.
Well... What happens is he kills me about 7 or 8 times, and then eventually I just barely kill him. I've done that before.
It's kind of embarrassing, but I do tend to sort of get lost when I'm going down that ladder maze at the start of Blighttown.
There's not a lot of places to go.
Yeah, but it's all very samey.
Oh, you mean in the shanty area, not at the very beginning?
Yeah, exactly. No, not the top of Blighttown, please.
Yeah, I mean, there's 2 paths.
No one, who even uses the top of Blighttown anymore?
I don't know.
Probably Josh, let's be honest.
Big jerks.
Oh, I fell down the bridge and died.
That's good news.
Yep. I fell down the bridge and died. I'm not very pleased about that. You might be.
Slightly, yeah.
I only did that so that I could get the Ring of Favor and Protection.
Fap ring.
You're welcome, chat. There you go. So that's what you've been doing this week, Nick.
Oh, this is among other things. I've also been playing some jazz punk. You were right, that game is pretty wild.
It's a wild game, yeah.
Very enjoyable and very weird.
Yeah, you've got all the right, you've hit all the right notes there.
Just about to finish the Let's Play that I'm doing on it, too. It's not a very long game, unfortunately.
It's like 4 hours?
Not even, I think. It was a half an hour per episode at 6 episodes, so Ooh. Actually, close.
Is it only 6 chapters, then?
No, I wasn't even doing one per chapter. I was actually splitting it up. I was just taking forever to go through each mission.
Well, how many missions are there, then?
I think it's like 4.
There's 4? Okay, so the furthest I got was to, like, the resort.
Yeah, right after that is the last mission.
What? No way.
It's the end.
I mean, that's okay. It's just...
I don't know how long the last mission is, but I'm going to guess, like, a half an hour.
I thought it was substantially longer than that. I thought it would be, like, a 10-mission game, which would still be very short.
Yep. Nope, it is not.
Yeah, I mean, it's still worth the money for tone and humor, I think. But if I had known that, that might have changed my what I said in my video slightly, at least.
Yeah, I kind of feel the same way. But, you know, at the same time, I had so much fun with it. I don't mind that much. I liked it enough that I wanted to play more of it.
Hey, man, you know, $15 for a 4-hour experience or a 3-hour experience that's pretty neat and novel is better than you get at the movie theater most of the time.
That's true.
It's very true, indeed. Except with the Lego movie. This stream is sponsored by Miramax Pictures. They came out with the Lego movie. You should go check it out. Go to legomovie.com/showtimes and input hashtag NLSS as your code, and that'll get you 0.69% off of your next movie ticket, as long as you purchase it directly through the Miramax store and you're buying more than 5 of them at a time or more, and also some restrictions may apply. If you live in Quebec or Hawaii, I'm sorry, but this doesn't work for you. And also, you can't use other coupons or promotions in conjunction with this.
What's with you and Lego Movie? You've been talking about this a lot.
I told you, man, they pumped a lot of money into the stream. They sponsored it today.
Oh, I didn't realize they actually sponsored it.
Sorry. This is Learn How to Block Wednesday on twitch.tv/northernlion. And that's what we're doing. What is a better fit for the target audience of the Lego movie than the classic action RPG, ultra-violent and dystopian. Is dystopic a word?
It should be. I
guess,
like it.
Despotic is a word, but that's not really the same thing.
Not quite the same. I think it's actually a really good fit, because honestly, Lego, the original Dockers, really, if you think about
it. Excuse me?
They've got a little, you know, the pegs, they fit together. They kind of dock a little.
Wow, Legos are the original dockers. You're correct. I'm
right,
poisoned.
Vaporing on.
Nick, I didn't even realize till now. This is going to blow your mind. I didn't realize I was poisoned and toxified as I was making my way through the end of Blighttown.
That's bad.
And I still made it to the bonfire.
Congrats.
I'm very pleased with myself, but...
I'm just about to go to Blighttown now, too. Did you have success getting down the whole way?
Yeah, I didn't fall this time. I thought about it, though.
It'd be a real crapshoot going down that water wheel.
Dude, the water wheel is, like, one of the very few parts in the game that has platforming elements that I just, like, cannot handle. Crystal Caves? No big deal, man.
Like, this game is not a platformer. It's not even close to one. And anytime they make you do platforming, it's like, it's basically 50-50.
Yeah. Which I find hilarious because Crazy Mike showed me that glitch and taught me that glitch where you can actually, like, get on top of the saw in Sen's Fortress.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
It looks real sweet if you can pull it off.
It does. I'm fighting Maneater Mildred.
Oh, wow. We're actually really close then.
She is, like, the greatest NPC at just taking damage but not doing any. Excuse me? Hey, we have a new subscriber. Kyle's killing it. Up down to the
good
side
to hear.
Of the Lion Pride. What's the matter? Could it be Kyle's Krillin' it from Dragon Ball
Krillin.
Z?
Why did he have those dots on his head? Do you know?
Dude, don't ask me questions about Dragon Ball Z. This is Michael A.L. Fox territory.
Oh. I guess he was a monk, probably, right? So that was kind of an insensitive thing to say. I wasn't really thinking there.
Is that a monkish thing?
I thought it was.
It's definitely a monkish thing from video games, I'll tell you that much. I don't know if it's a monkish thing in real life. It may be, it may not be. Who knows?
Chad knows. We know that much.
I killed Maneater Mildred.
All right.
And I can't rest at my bonfire?
I'm going down low.
Not being able to rest at that bonfire typically means you're being invaded, right?
Mm-hmm. Usually.
Oh, man.
Are you going to get the gold-helmed robes when you get past
Quaylog? No. Nick, I told you, this is how I beat the game.
I just don't know what your usual patterns are at this point.
I do things...
Oh, crap.
I don't get poisoned. Whatever you say I am. If I wasn't, then why would I say I am? Exactly.
In the paper, the news, every day I am.
You know more of the lyrics than I do.
How many more lines do I have to do before the copyright claim?
It's 5 seconds, right?
Yeah, something like that.
So that email told us. I can't...
Fucking mosquitoes, man. Can't believe how much M&M I remember.
Yeah, like peanut flavored.
Those are good. The pretzel, too. The pretzel's really good.
Dude, pretzel plus chocolate is a classic... It's a neoclassical combination.
I was raving about those... I forgot what brand they were now, but I had some chocolate-covered pretzels the other day that were so good.
I believe they were rolled gold.
Yeah, wow, you remember my pretzels better than I do.
This is a good time to point out that today's stream has been sponsored by Hostess Frito-Lay. They are the fine purveyors of the Rolled Gold Pretzel Group, the number one pretzel corporation in America since 1974. So you go check out their chocolate and yogurt flavored covered varieties. It says on this card here, they are delectable. Back to you.
The Pretzel Group.
Dark Spirit Wealthy Hornet has invaded. I was just waiting for the invasion. Because I don't have any Estus, so I'm already a dead man walking. So, here we go. Bring it on,
better
man.
Than a Christopher walking, right?
Yeah, I'm already poisoned as well, so basically, like, fuck it, I should just kill myself. Oh, wait, who's this guy? Hampered Clock 63. I'll
I really wish there was a way to kill these damn mosquitoes forever.
Yeah, I know, right?
Just forever. Mm-hmm. Eternally dead.
Yeah. So it sounds like a romance movie about vampires. I'm not going to use any humanity. Whatever, poison. Poison just killed me. Every rose has its thorn indeed.
I don't know about that.
Oh, now these summons are going to fight each other. Enjoy yourselves. Use humanity to heal. I'm not going to waste humanity that I actually need to get further in the game.
Wait, am I human? Reverse hollowing.
Excuse me?
I'm not hollow. Okay.
Scoopington. Up down to the side. Welcome to the Lion Pride. Thank you very much for that subscription.
There's no visual cue that just says, like, you're human, right?
Well,
you just gotta go check. Your skin, but if you can't see it because you're covered.
Wow, you're using armor too?
For a split second, I was like, wait.
You think you know some people? I'm naked, man.
Okay.
Of course I'm doing my speedrun naked. It makes you run faster.
You could be a big beef jerky man, then.
Excuse me?
You can bait the dragon and jerky.
You're the bitter, Nick.
We'll see about that.
You're entitled to do whatever you want with your life. I'm just saying.
This swamp kind of looks like we're running through grits, doesn't it?
Through grits?
Yeah, a little bit like grits.
I've never eaten grits.
You're not missing a whole lot, in my opinion.
When I moved to Korea, I took over the apartment of, like, a lady from the southern United States. And there were, like, 12 packages of grits. And she's like, well, you know, if you like grits, here you go. You can have some. And I was like, I've never had grits. And I left that apartment a year later, and there was still 10 packages of grits left there.
They'll last. Don't get me wrong. They'll be around.
I wonder if those grits are still in that apartment.
I keep thinking in one time I'm going to like them because I like the concept of them, but I just don't like the taste and the texture of them.
What are grits? What are they made of?
It's, what is it, like a potato thing? Something
like potatoes.
Like that. Maybe I'm wrong. It might not even be that. All right, let's fight Quaalog.
Oh, dude, just wait out a second.
Why? You want me to wait in a speed run?
I'm waiting for my summon to show up. You should just wait a little bit. I'm standing right outside of the spider hole.
I'm alright.
Oh, come on, man.
I'm gonna fight Quaalog, if we could. I'm also gonna get her Fury Sword.
You don't get that for killing Quaalog.
I do.
Wow, you got some secrets, man. Those grits
really
haunt him to this day. It's true!
Alright.
Apparently grits are made out of cornmeal, Nick.
Yeah, that's right. I'm sorry. Potatoes.
I don't know if I'm as into that.
All right, Maneater Mildred, do your work.
Hey, we have two messages on Skype. Let me see if some of these, as I try not to die of poison, are Josh.
They're not. I don't have those messages.
Okay. Oh, just it's Blood
Bowl. Oh, God, don't stand in the lava, idiot.
Blood Bowl chat.
Dead.
You're dead?
Yeah.
I told you to wait, man.
Totally botched that first encounter.
Here, I'll tell you what. I'll wait for you. This is Dark Souls speedrun. Man, the guys who hold the world record in Dark Souls must have really good internet, am I right?
No. Don't wait for me, just run.
No, I'm not waiting for you. I'm waiting for the summon.
Should've used my gold pine resin.
Yeah, you still have gold pine resin left.
Yeah, I never used it on the gargoyles because they're so easy.
Damn, dog. I know I'm streaming right now, but I would still love for someone to be able to join my games. Scoobington. You did officially subscribe. I remember. I saw it. I said, Scoobington, welcome to the Lion Pride. You have a great name. It's just good to say. It kind of feels like it has a weight in your mouth, doesn't it? Scoobington.
I don't like a lot of weights in my mouth, but yeah, I like that one.
Nick, how awesome would it be if next year for Awesome Games Done Quick, there was a Dark Souls segment, and like you and I didn't get to play, obviously, because we're mad, because we're bad, but we got like to invade people?
Yes.
Like, that is what I want. We got to invade the speedrunners as a...
Oh, and we got to ruin the speedrunners' run live on TV.
Exactly.
I would trust that only with Crazy Mike.
Excuse me? Crazy Mike's too good. It would just ruin the... It would be awesome games, you know...
Destroyed in front of everyone.
Exactly. Ergo, me smart. Up, down, to the side. Welcome to the Lion Pride. I guess I'm just going to go, fight Quaalog.
Can you imagine if that was actually a thing? Like, the speedrunners knew if you see a man on top of the pendulum, reset.
They call it the Crazy Mike mechanic.
Right. Strat. I think everything's a strat, right?
Is it? I don't know. I'm pretty big into the speedrunning community, as you can tell, as a result of my content. But I actually don't know enough about it to tell you. Nick, how much damage does your weapon do per hit?
Not enough.
That's not an
That's
answer.
That's all I know.
Summoning failed. Oh, no kidding. I didn't notice based on the fact that there was nobody in my game.
All right, Mildred, let's do this. Round two.
I'm doing like 33 damage per hit, which is not enough.
That's what I said, not enough.
Yeah,
same.
But you could be doing 100 and still not be enough.
It's not going to be 100.
Well, Maneater Mildred just keeps running into the lava over and over, so...
Well, on Quaalog, I'm doing 20 with two-handed, so that is not anything.
Oh, yeah, that's actually worse.
That's horrible. What is going on with that?
That's a good question, man. Maneater Mildred
actually doesn't even make sense.
Maneater Mildred is half dead and has not even touched Quaalog.
Gotta work on that.
The AI for Maneater Mildred is actually comical in its inefficiency.
Oh, come on, throw fireballs further than that.
I'll actually do 66 damage with a two-hand halberd shot.
I don't think I'm going to be able to fight it like this.
You should just upgrade your Uchi Katana, man.
Yeah, but then I got to take a side trip, like, way out of here.
Now you know how I live my whole life. Just not wanting to do anything. You want to be like me, Nick? The answer to that question should be no.
No?
There you go.
All right, fireballs are not a good idea for a fire-based enemy.
Wow, you're a pyromancer? Look at this cheater over here. You should be a knight like all the cool kids.
Knights are pretty cool, though.
That was my first starting class in Dark Souls ever.
Oh, I mean in life, not in, like, Dark Souls. They're not that good here.
You heard it here first? Wow, I actually did not get hit by Quaalog's scream. I'm a very lucky man. Oh, is that another scream? No, it's just lava. Maneater Mildred, ultimate distraction.
No! I knew the scream was coming. I didn't roll in time, so I got stuck in the leg. I was going to kill it that time, too.
I find that hard to believe.
No, I had it down, three quarters down.
Yeah, three quarters down.
Yeah.
How did you do so much damage, Nick?
I used one of my two gold pine resins.
You still have two gold pine resins left.
I used one.
Absolute scum.
What do you want me to do? Not use them? Just leave them to just language and
yeah.
inventory?
You're not allowed to use anything that I don't have anymore. That's just science, Nick.
That actually might be science.
Starring Mel Gibson and Joaquin Phoenix.
Is that how you pronounce the last name? I didn't realize it was quite so accentuated at the end.
Most people think it's Phoenix, like the bird, but it's not.
Joaquin Phoenix.
Yeah, exactly. Nick, I'm going to beat Quaalog.
Yeah, I was there a second ago. Not anymore.
Maneater Mildred doing work? Are you fucking kidding me, chat? Are you seeing this? Maneater Mildred isn't doing shit. It's all Maneater Quick Bro.
Scumdrid.
She actually is a scum. She's, like, real mad. Phantom Maneater Mildred has been vanquished. Alright, here's the moment of truth, I guess, then. Oh, okay. There you go. Dodge that, and then just... Oh, 16 damage. There you go, that's a lot.
I should have gotten some kind of armor. Because I'm still rolling the starting armor.
Nick, I have no shirt on. No shirt, no pants. Just gloves!
No service.
I would not be getting service! Maybe
you
that's
go in a convenience store, they're going to tell you to leave.
Maybe that's why my internet went out. They're like, this guy's not following the rules.
Yeah. No shirt, no shoes, no shirt, no internet.
Yeah, that would be a shitty rule, man. I think predominant use of the internet is... Oh, shit.
Shirtless.
No, get out of... No, run! I ran.
Hey, I don't use the internet shirtless very often.
Is that true?
I don't think it's not true.
I don't think it's not true. I gotcha. I don't think it's not true.
You can just work on that one for a bit.
I'm thinking about
puzzle.
It. Dude, Quaalog Spider, you need to vomit some more so that I can actually have a chance to Estus. There we go. Okay. This is a big moment. Chat, stop telling me no Bukkake, no deal.
Well, they got a point, though.
It's just science again.
All right, Mildred, let's do it this time. No screams.
Dude, Nick,
no
you
whammy.
Can't use Maneater Mildred.
Yeah, well, I'm doing it.
You can't.
You told me to not do a lot of things, and I'm not listening.
I already told you you can't take that shortcut if you want to be taken seriously in the Dark Souls.
I didn't actually take this shortcut in the end. The dragon wouldn't come down.
Oh, all right. Come on, Quaalog. Don't F with my butt here.
It's either this one or nothing for a while, because this is my last gold pine resin.
Oh! Nick, I'm submerged in lava!
That's really bad. You gotta get out of there, man.
Quaalog is like 99% dead. Now Chad just exclusively says no Bukkake, no deal. I can't believe I don't see this coming.
Man, you're Mildred, what are you doing? Get out of the lava!
Just do one more attack! Oh shit, Quaalog's dead, yo!
Well, grats.
Thank you very much, Nick. I appreciate that a great deal. That was a more difficult fight than it should have been. I got her soul. I'm just gonna do what everyone does with Quaalog's soul and pop the shit out of it and turn it into stats. Oh,
is that really what they do? I don't think they do that.
Yeah, dude, you can't even make a weapon out of it. Most people don't know that.
I don't think they do that.
So we're 72 minutes in. Just rang the second bell. I'm pretty sure that's a world record split time.
Mildred, Do not mess with me. This is our only chance. Oh, God. Don't kill me. Don't kill me. Don't kill me.
Looks like Maneater Mildred was doing work. Don't even talk to me, chat, about what Maneater Mildred did. I saw Maneater Mildred. She didn't do anything.
My pine resin wore off. That's really bad. I've got a lot of humanity, so I don't really care.
I don't really understand what you're doing that is causing you to tap buttons so quickly. What's up with that?
I'm trying to roll. I'm stunned. I'm trying to roll out of the way.
I gotcha.
What do? You just tank every hit?
No, I only hit the roll button once, though. I'm not playing Marvel vs. Capcom 69.
You gotta catch those frames, man. If you tap it real fast, you'll do much better.
I think you actually just catch the spirit and catch the spit.
Mostly the spit. If you want to be technical about it.
Yeah, if you want to be technical about it, you got to get with my friends. We already covered this earlier in the show. Maneater, do work. The role of the distraction. That's a Romanian film coming out this summer.
I would not watch it.
I would watch the shit out of it. Nick, are you familiar with The Room?
Oh, yeah, kind of only through you, though.
Okay.
I got to watch that.
I know a lot of chat is going to be familiar with The Room. You know, if you're not familiar with it, basically the most brazenly terrible movie ever made, but also great because it's made with genuine love and confidence, which makes it so much better. Like, if someone's really nervous about giving, like, a public speech, and then they suck really bad at it, you just feel bad. But if someone is like, I'm gonna kill this speech, and then they fuck it up royally, you're like, oh, that's some good comedy right there. And that's basically what The Room is in a nutshell. And one of the co-actors, who is actually, you know, mentally sane in the movie, one of the co-stars, wrote a book about its production that came out in the fall, and I just picked it up last week, and it's called The Disaster Artist, and it's real entertaining. I've been reading that.
Do you have any idea how my starting hatchet weapon could be better than the Uchigatana?
I'm pretty sure I got to Anne Orlando just using the hatchet.
Well, because it's doing 29 damage when the Uchigatana does 20, so...
Wow, that's weird.
What is that about?
Well, how about this, Nick? Uncrustables fans.
Don't do this.
Just subscribe if you're interested.
We don't need to do this, though. No more Uncrustables.
Uncrustables fan 69. He's the 69th fan. Someone also said the book of The Disaster Artist, which is not The Room, but is the book based on the production of The Room, has been optioned for a movie. I did hear that. That's pretty cool as well. It's going to be interesting to see if that actually gets made. I hope it does. Many things that get optioned don't, but still, that'd be real cool.
It's not the final option.
The final sacrifice.
All right. Steven Seagal.
Oh, right. You were doing a Steven Seagal reference. I went for Mystery Science Theater 2000.
If only they could cross over sometimes.
I can't believe they haven't. There's got to be some riff tracks, at least, of Steven Seagal movies. I would be
very
surprised.
He's done some pretty goofy shit, hasn't he?
Yeah, he's also... He looks really funny when he runs.
Does he? I haven't watched him run much.
You just, like, YouTube Steven Seagal running.
There's probably a whole channel devoted to it.
There's a video that I've watched probably, like, three times a year since 2006. I know the song off by heart, unfortunately.
Oh, wow. I am one hit away from death again.
You can do it, Nick. I was there. I was right there with you, man. You can make it. I have faith in you.
It's going to take me 10,000 years to kill her, though. I mean, this hatchet sucks.
You should get the... You probably have the halberd, man.
Yeah, I should probably just stop what I'm doing and look through my inventory. Well, no, I'm dead, so I think you won.
No, Nick, there's still 45 minutes left.
That's a long time.
45 minutes left, and I got to get through Sen's Fortress.
I think you won, actually.
We'll see.
You may have broken my spirit.
I don't want to break your spirit. I want to lift your spirit up like a Creed song in your moment of need.
That would be cool.
Yeah, I want to take you higher.
Doo-doo-doo-doo-doo.
Yeah, to a place where blind men see.
That is what he says. I never knew that.
I think he's talking about heaven.
Oh. Mm. Oh. I thought it was just like a place where blind men see.
Let me take you higher to a place where blind men see... Let me take you higher to the place where old men weep? Is that the second part of that?
Really? That's creepy.
Because that sounds like... The first part is like, yeah, you know, that's uplifting. Give them their sense of sight back. But the second part is like, why are these old people crying? Did they run like a factory that subsisted on blind workers or something, and now they're economically ruined?
That's awful.
Well, I didn't come up with it. You got to take this up with Scott Stapp, man.
I will. I will after the stream.
Yeah, he's a. You find him on the professional celebrity poker tour.
I'll tweet at him. I'll see if he talks to me.
Oh, God. You know, I shouldn't say this because I have no idea. He might be the nicest guy in the world. But it would also not surprise me if Scott Stapp had no sense of humor about his career.
Yeah, me either.
He strikes me just from, you know, the way he sings and the way he writes the songs that he
Passionate.
Sings. Passionate. Yeah, and like, you know, confident. Oblivious might be another word that you could use if you wanted to put a negative spin on it.
You didn't do that, though.
Completely unaware of the self.
Hey, these are things that people could come to the conclusion of, but clearly we're not doing
people
that.
Much crueler than myself, yes.
Right.
Of course.
Am I ignoring a sub like a total scum? Okay, let me not do that as soon as I get to this summon point again.
Do you have more humanity?
I got plenty of humanity. I'm not worried about that.
Well, that's good, then.
It's just the gold pine resin. That was the end of that.
Mmm.
Uncrustable fan 69. Just thank you, Uncrustables fan 69.
Gotcha.
I don't know what I should say. Well, thank you for joining the Rock Quarry. I appreciate it, regardless of your alliance with Uncrustables.
Absolutely, man. Chad. Sometimes I look over at Chad and I forget about things to be said like 30 seconds ago.
Mm-hmm.
The whole Bukkake thing is still going on.
That's been a while ago. Now.
Yeah, you know, the mid-90s, I think. Basically the rise of the internet.
Was there really like a big, like a rise of Bukkake, do you think?
That's a Romanian movie coming out this summer. Alright, I actually forgot how to do the starting part of Sen's Fortress.
You run through all the things.
Man, remember when, I don't know if this happened to you, but the first time I played Dark Souls, to get to Sen's Fortress and then through Sen's Fortress probably took me like 3 weeks.
Oh, it was a while, yeah. The whole time of me playing the game, my first, from starting to finishing the game was like 3 or 4 months.
Oh, I got invaded already.
I actually stopped playing it at one point, too.
Oh, really? You gave up?
I wouldn't say I gave up, but I got kind of frustrated and just decided that I had better things to do for a while.
I actually almost gave up on the Anne Orlando Archers.
Mm, yeah, they're the second hardest point, or maybe the hardest point. Let's try the Morning Star. Let's see if Quaylag doesn't like the Morning Star now.
I can't believe I got invaded.
Nope, Quaylag does not mind the Morning Star.
This guy's got a halberd as well. He's coming at me with like exactly the same gear. At least, you know, much respect for that.
I've never had trouble with the camera before in this boss fight, but it's actually giving me a hard time today.
The camera during the Quaylag boss fight?
Yeah, it's like clipping into the walls and stuff and making like a long view when I don't want it.
That's a Green Day.
Yeah, it's been a while since Dookie came out. 20 years, in fact.
Not for me. Dookie means poop. I pooped this morning.
Oh, I get it. I hope it wasn't green.
No, it was not green. Oh, I died. Congratulations, you're pure scum.
Well,
that's all right. I guess I shouldn't
be. But your knife is not good either.
Oh, yeah, you're pretty good. Can't help but notice that you have armor on and are not naked.
I like leather armor.
Maybe I should put some clothes on. Nah. Alright, well, I did pretty well in that invasion anyway.
I have a gargoyle helm. I guess I can wear that.
Nah, Nick. No helmets allowed.
Hollow armor.
No helmets allowed.
If I was to tell you that there was a sex act known as threading the barrel, and without going on Urban Dictionary, what would you predict that that might be?
Threading the barrel.
Yeah.
I'm going to say that... You put your penis in another dude's urethra?
Well, that's a pretty good guess, but that's not it.
Okay.
Wow, can people do that? I don't want to think about
that's
that.
That's what I was running through my head. I don't know if it's physically possible, but it's a wild place out there.
Maybe it's a theoretical sex act. No,
exactly.
This is when you you put a spool of twine or soft thread or fabric into the anus, and then you slowly pull it out.
Oh, yeah. They have a name for that now.
Of course they do.
I just call that Thursday nights.
Isn't that sushi night? Oh no, that's Tuesday.
Oh my god, Nick.
Every day.
One of the fucking man-eater serpents managed to survive to the second bridge with the sorcerer lightning man.
Yeah?
So I died.
You have a problem.
I did. I like when you said theoretical sex acts, because it conjured the image of, like, a sexual Stephen Hawking or something like that.
Oh, my God.
Who is, like, doing theoretical sex research.
Oh, sexual Stephen Hawking just followed me on Twitter.
I like that name a lot, sexual Stephen Hawking.
The alliteration.
Yeah, it is the alliteration and then also the juxtaposition, and not to be cruel, but obviously.
Yeah, it's reality, unfortunately.
Exactly. The idea of a sexual Stephen Hawking, just it is a little bit absurd. But maybe he's killer in the sack, I don't know.
I'm going to not do the voice that I was thinking of doing for a second, because I think that's just insensitive.
Yeah, no, I agree with you. You know, have utmost respect for what is undoubtedly one of the smartest men on the planet.
He's a goddamn genius.
He's pretty smart. Like, he's accomplished more with his life than I'll ever accomplish with my life. Unless I, beat Dark Souls in the next 45 minutes, in which case I'll basically be the, Souls Stephen Hawking. See, the alliteration just isn't there anymore.
Yeah, you're right. It doesn't work as well. Alright, let's do this again, Coilag. I'm saying your name differently every time I say it, by the way.
Yeah, and when no one is around, say baby I love you, if you ain't running game.
Maybe I am running game.
Well, you should stop then.
Don't hate the player, hate the game.
I know. I've talked to you about this before. Wait, Ace36, up down to the side, welcome to the Lion Pride. But I always thought that, Destiny's Child sounds a little bit unreasonable in the song known as Say My Name.
What about the one with the bills?
Well, okay, we'll talk about that in a second, because that's straight up bullshit. But it's say my name, when nobody's around you, say baby I love you. I'm like,
right,
why?
So when you're just by yourself.
Why do you want me to talk to myself when you're not here? That seems like unreasonable.
Yeah. Like, with your hands in your pockets and your hood down, just going, I love you, baby.
Exactly.
I love you.
If
love
you ain't
you
running
so
game. So in the mind of the child of Destiny, there are two possibilities.
Not an RPG.
Child of Destiny. Either there's two possibilities if you're a man. Either you are muttering to yourself about how much you love your girlfriend by yourself, with no impetus except for that, the love burns deep within your heart, or you're running game.
Yep.
And I don't even know what that means. How can I be accused of something if I don't even know what it means?
That means you're like doing a bunch of women.
Is that what that is?
Running, it's like you're trying to trick everybody into thinking you're the only one, but actually you have a bunch of girlfriends.
Is that what running game is?
I don't know. I've never done it, but I assume that's what that meant.
That's what running game is, then. I had no idea.
Oh, Mildred's stuck in the white fog wall. That's really going to help me with this fight. You want to turn around, then? Yeah, there you are. Hi.
Wait, okay, so I think I've forgotten at this point. It's been a long time since, the summer of 1998.
Keep paying my bills.
Yeah.
Keep paying my automobiles. Keep paying my telephone bills.
Does she say
bills.
That? So she's actually advocating that the man pays for everything.
And if you did, then maybe we can chill.
Is that what? Wow, that is a bad message.
I don't think you do, so you and me are through. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do.
Wow, that is like straight up.
I knew that one was shitty right the first time I heard it.
Wow, I didn't, because I was just dazzled by the hooks. But my lord, that is not a message that I want today's youth to hear about. I mean, we're done. That influence has already percolated, through us. We've been grossly affected by it.
Well, if anything, maybe the next generation just didn't hear that song, so maybe they're just going to be a much better generation.
I
than
hope
us.
So. I think
that's probably true.
Beyonce has started to, be a little bit more positive in the way that she kind of treats her culture and our culture. I don't know, that came out definitely the way that I did not want it to. But, the way that she talks to people, I think, has become a little bit more respectful and empowering. But, my lord, don't suggest that unless a man pays for your things, then you're done. That sends the wrong message about everybody involved in that kind of social interaction.
Maybe there's more context that we're not aware of.
Well, then they should make that clear. It should be a ballad, not just a ditty.
No, Diddy didn't write that one.
He might have. He was prolific in the late 90s and early 2000s.
You're right, he may have written that one, actually. Diddy probably wrote that one.
Nick, the fucking mimic takes 100 years to kill.
You just throw fireballs at him and you're fine.
I'm not a pyromancer.
Should have been. I'm still fighting Quelaag like 10 damage at a time, so I'm not the person to talk to.
Actually, that's, everyone was mad at me for not being a pyromancer. I don't know why I thought being a knight would be better. I guess because you start with armor, and then I just didn't wear it.
The gargoyle helms helped me a little bit in this fight. It doesn't one-shot me now when she screams.
This is going to take 1,000 years.
And this isn't.
Well, you know, Nick, I don't know what to tell you.
I've pretty much screwed myself on this run. Like, I need to just leave and go get better gear.
You don't need better gear. I'm not even wearing anything.
Then what am I using? Like, I have an Uchi Katana that doesn't do shit for damage. I've got fireballs that don't do any damage. And I've got a hatchet that doesn't do any damage.
You don't have the halberd?
I don't think so.
If you got the key to get down to lower on Deadberg, you should have the halberd.
Hmm. I'll wait for the next cycle and then I'll check through my inventory.
You know, if we play this long enough, we'll end up on the same cycle.
Oh, because we're roommates.
Exactly.
Like digital roommates.
Digital roommates, yeah, has now followed you on Twitter.
Sims 4.
What? It's for pooping, silly.
What is there to change about The Sims at this point, by the way? Do you know? Is there another reason for buying another Sims?
We're going to find out, man. Sims 4 is coming out this year.
That's why I'm bringing it up, because yeah. I just saw it, and I'm like, what? Why?
What's The Sims for? It's for pooping, silly?
They'll blur that out, though.
Will they? I don't know if they have the sack to blur it out.
I think they have to.
Okay.
Have you seen that animated GIF when they have Yahoo or Woohoo or whatever they call it? I died again. I'm dead. I'm just out.
Don't give up on me, Nick.
They pulled the curtain, or the curtain and the sheets back, and they're just like contorting themselves in a circle on the bed.
I did see that, and it blew my mind, and then it gave me a new mind, which completely changed the way that I looked at the world.
Did it blow that one too? Because it did for me.
You got like a triple mind blow from that.
Yeah, it blew multiple minds.
This is a double dragon mine.
Double dragon mine.
Have you played Double Dragon Neon yet?
Not yet. I'm gonna, though.
That game's real hard. It's kind of good, though.
We play it together, right? Because we can co-op in it.
It has online bro-op, indeed.
I'm glad you referred to it that way.
Well, I think it actually does call it bro-op in the game. Because it's from, like, 2011 or something, you know? It's a simpler time.
Dude, I suggested to 2DX, the developers of Bosses Forever, that they change the title screen to say bro-op, and I think they did.
Nice.
So I thought I invented that, but I guess
I thought that was like a term that existed previously to describe like Gears of War.
Oh. I liked chainsawing couches in half in that game. I'm going to give them that.
I have never played a Gears of War game.
But you're missing out on so much.
That's not me trying to be snobby. I just like... For every time that a game released, I had an excuse not to play it. It was like...
Dozens of hours of nothing going on.
The first one came out in like 2007, and I think I was like, I was like, I'm in school right now, I don't have time to play that. And then Gears of War 2 was like 2008, and I was still in school. And then Gears of War 3 was like, I'm in South Korea right now, I can't get to, where am I going to buy Gears of War for the Xbox 360? And then
is there any reason to go to the Great Hollow right now?
There's never any reason to go to the Great Hollow ever, Nick.
Yeah, I think you're actually right about that.
No, there's no thinking necessary. Bill Collins album, no thinking required.
I thought it was called Don't Go to the Great Hollow in Dark Souls.
It is. He's a poet and he didn't even know it. Oh, I should become human so I can summon Tarkus. Good idea, chat. I just saw someone. I'm so happy that we could bring you this knowledge. I got the bonfire in Sense Fortress and then somebody said, there's a bonfire there?
Yes!
I think this is one of the few things I looked up the first time I played Dark Souls. I was like, I got to the top of Sense Fortress and was like, whoo, definitely won't be able to do that in 12 minutes anytime in the near future. Better find a bonfire. And then, yeah, there it is. You gotta walk off the edge.
See, my chat's telling me I should go run to the blacksmith to upgrade my stuff. And this is where my laziness comes in.